my little party animals. Hiphiprenee here today with a brand new speed build for you. And this speed build is part of hiphiprebuilds, which is where I am rebuilding every single world in The Sims. And I'm making, I think, some pretty decent headway on this. I'm not doing too bad. It's still obviously a very large, very daunting task, but I am having a lot of fun with it. And this is actually going to be the first community lot for hiphiprebuilds. So I have been working at a yoga studio for the last few months or so, and I know that I have built yoga studios and spas in the past, but I really enjoy building these. It's really fun. I think that they always turn out pretty cool. You can go a ton of different directions with them. And I really wanted to do another one. So here's another one. So this is actually, I've decided to call it Namaste Business Park because it is not just a yoga studio. I was originally going to do just a yoga studio, and I've had a really hard time recently trying to come up with inspiration without actually using physical inspiration. And by that, I mean like not going on Pinterest and looking up, you know, different types of builds or different types of buildings. I've had a really hard time just building like from my brain recently. So I was going to do a yoga studio and I was thinking about it and I was like, all right, let me think of the types of yoga studios that I've gone to in the past because I have been to plenty of them. The yoga studio that I am in now is actually in like a little business park. It's more of an older style business park. The yoga studio that I attend and work for is actually in like an old mill building. If you guys don't know this, I live in New England, and I am in the area of New England where if you ever read Liddy when you were in fifth grade like we did, we talk about mill buildings here all the time because we really were, you know, one of the major areas for textile mills in, you know, in the United States when they first started. So the yoga studio that I am in is inside of a mill building, and I was thinking about it and I was like, you know, it's in Willow Creek, so I don't think a mill style building is really appropriate. So I decided I wanted to do more of like a strip mall kind of idea, but I didn't want to go, you know, like super new with the strip mall. I wanted to look like maybe this building had been something else in the past. Maybe it's been refurbished, repurposed. So I don't know what this building could have been, but I think it turned out really cute. I am a little disappointed that I did not go back in and add more ivy to the outside because I do feel like the outside is a little bit boring. And I was talking to a few of my Sims friends yesterday while I was working on this, and Jordan, my friend Jordan, hi Jordan, had suggested that I do add more ivy to the outside, either add more ivy or take off what I had already done because it was like not enough. Maybe it needed a little bit more, but I don't know. I got lazy, so I'm sorry. I do think it looks pretty cool. I think the insides here, however, are definitely the more fun kind of areas in this build. So this is not just a yoga studio like I had already mentioned. This is a yoga studio, a coffee shop, and a juice shop. So I thought all three of those things really kind of go very well together because there are a few different types of people that you commonly see at yoga classes. And two of the ones that really kind of sprang to mind were, you know, the crunchy granola type of people who, you know, they really enjoy doing their shakes and that kind of stuff. And maybe they like a little kind of down home family coffee shop where they can grab, you know, some vegan food or something. And then there's another type of person that also takes yoga. Obviously, there's tons of people that take yoga, but these are like the two stereotypical kind of people that I tend to notice do yoga. And the other type are the super ultra fit. And they tend to do yoga because most of the time in a regular workout class, if you attend like, you know, Zumba or HIIT or anything like that, you're not going to have a ton of stretching. Obviously, you will stretch throughout the class at some points, but it's not like a full, like, here's an hour long of stretching. So yoga really tends to be where a lot of very fit people tend to get their stretching in. So I thought putting a juice shop where, you know, they could go in and buy their protein shakes and that kind of thing, and then also a little coffee shop where maybe they could go in, sit down with their laptop, get some work done, and then head next door to the yoga studio. I thought that was a really cute idea. So the first place we are working on is the coffee shop. Now, I did not name these individually because, you know, it's all one lot. And actually, the lot is technically, it's a spa, because I really wanted the yoga studio to be the focus. I wanted that to be the functional bit of this particular build. And I did notice when I was going in to take my screenshots that really kind of everything seemed pretty functional. There was somebody working at the juice bar. There were people working at the massage tables in this yoga studio. There was a yoga instructor. I think at one point somebody was working in the coffee shop as well. So, you know, it is functional from what I have seen from my screenshots. I didn't actually play in this, but it is all functional to my knowledge. So let me know down in the comments below if you downloaded this, if it is, you know, really, really functional, or if it's, you know, maybe, you know, sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. I would be very happy to see that. I am probably going to use it at some point once I finish up doing my hip rebuild series. It is a save file that I definitely want to play in, but obviously with it being so empty right now, it just, you know, kind of seems like a waste to play in it because it's just going to continually populate townies on me, and I want to make sure that I have full control over this save file right down to the townies. So I'm sure that now I've taken screenshots in here that there's a few townies that I'm going to have to get rid of, but it's okay. I will make do. I will get rid of them. But I think this coffee shop turned out really cute. So we have, you know, just some nice seating right around the actual bar area in the coffee shop, if that's what you want to call it. And then we have a cute little seating area with just some books and some notebooks and things like that. I used a few of the new free items that we got in the patch. Was it last week? I don't remember exactly when we got this patch, but it was very, very recent. So I did use some of those items. I thought that was a cute little idea. Maybe some freelance writers come here and this is where they work. I just really wanted this to be, you know, a nice, cozy coffee shop area. So you'll notice the side with the actual like coffee bar on it is very light and bright and airy. There's a lot of yellows and whites and that kind of thing. And then over on this end, I did end up putting down a few tables. There's really not too much more than this, to be honest. I wanted to make sure that there was plenty of floor space in case there were a lot of Sims coming in here to order coffee. I feel like sometimes in the cafes and things like that, the lines can get a little out of control. So I wanted to make sure we had space for your Sims to be able to move around. But that little seating area over on the right side of the building is very dark, and I think it still works out really nicely. It all kind of flows very well together, and I really do enjoy the way this particular section of this build turned out. I'm pretty happy with it. And then obviously just two bathrooms. All of the bathrooms in this build, I am pretty sure, are unisex. I want to say that I did every single one with unisex bathrooms, but I could be wrong. I could have done one of them with, you know, strictly male, strictly female. I don't really remember. And then each of these, so actually not each of them, well, they, just kidding, each of them. They all have two bathrooms and they all have an office. The juice bar and the coffee shop both have the exact same layout, and then the yoga studio is actually bigger than both of those because it takes up the entire left side of the building, so the layout is a little bit different on that, and I think it works out fine. So we are now moving into the juice shop, and I wanted this to be, you know, not quite as rustic as the coffee shop. The coffee shop feels very homey, like you could go there and it's okay if you want to put your feet up on the coffee table, like it's totally fine. I wanted this to kind of feel opposite of that. I feel like any time that I've been into a smoothie shop or anything, they have been very kind of sterile. And I don't know why that is. I don't know if it's just the aesthetic that they're going for or if, you know, there's really a reason for that. But I wanted to make sure that I was going, you know, very nice, bright, and almost kind of a modern little feel here. And I just say modern because I feel like a lot of black and white sleek items really kind of screams modern to me. So that's what I was going for here. And this sidewall over here, I think this sidewall is my favorite or one of my favorite bits of this particular build. I think it's really funny because I don't know if you guys know this about me. I think I mentioned this in the first part of my HOA series that the second part will be coming. Don't worry, guys. I know you're concerned. It's coming. So I had talked about that and I had mentioned that one of the families, the mother in the family was going to be part of a multi-level marketing scheme or a pyramid scheme. So if you guys don't know what a multi-level marketing scheme is, basically it's any type of quote unquote business where your ultimate goal really isn't to sell product. It's really more to recruit other people to sell product. So you end up making a cut of their money. And obviously, you know, with it being a pyramid scheme, the people at the top make a lot of money and the people at the bottom don't quite make as much money because, you know, the people at the top have already pulled a ton of people under their wings to be able to sell for them. So the market of finding, they call themselves consultants usually, is usually pretty small. If you need an example of any of these multi-level marketing, think things like LuLaRoe, Unique, It Works. There's a ton of them out there. Mary Kay, Avon. There are so many of them. So I kind of thought that this juice shop, the owner would be, you know, kind of a higher up in a multi-level marketing scheme. So this side area over here has a bunch of tea bags. It has some of the little jar things that we got from Get Famous that I'm pretty sure you use them in commercials. It's like a product that your Sim would sell, but there's like three little boxes stacked up and then, you know, a few bottles kind of laying around. So I figured that maybe the owner of this particular location was very much into whatever his crazy multi-level marketing scheme is, and he is trying to sell, you know, these little weight loss bottles and these weight loss teas and that kind of thing. So I thought that was really funny just to add in. If you're curious as to why all of that stuff is there, that's the reasoning behind it. I wanted to do something that I thought was, you know, kind of funny. So over here, we do also have another seating area, and I don't know what my issue was trying to figure out what to put in the seating area. I really wanted to use this high back chair, but we don't have anything that looks really good with it because I didn't want to do a high back chair on the other side because I felt like that looked really strange. So I do end up going through just a ton of different little couches and love seats and that kind of thing. And I do end up just changing it. So these are both, I'm pretty sure, from Get Famous. And I decided just to match them, have it be the same, stop overthinking things, and just, you know, do what I know is going to work. And then just obviously sticking a few plants in and around this area. And I believe I do some tables, not too many though. Again, I didn't want to take up a ton of space. I like, especially when I'm on community lots, I like places for my Sims to be able to move around and not be super concerned that they're just gonna, you know, kind of walk into things constantly or get, you know, that whole thing where they do the waving and they're like, hey, I can't go anywhere. I did not want that to happen. So this lot, surprisingly enough for me, is very playable. You guys know that I don't normally playtest my builds, but I have been playing around with screenshots and I finally figured out how to use like the tab screenshots. So I've been having Sims visit in or live in the lots that I have been taking screenshots of and having them, you know, just kind of be around in the area. And I've been including them in my screenshots, which has been really fun so far. I think it looks really cute to kind of, you know, have some sort of busyness going on in the background with your Sims, especially with community lots like this. It makes it feel just so much more alive and so much more fun. So that's really what I've been aiming for recently. And then, of course, over here, this is their office. So this is really just kind of more of a storage area for this particular build. They don't have a computer or anything like that. There are computers in the other locations in this little strip mall kind of area, but not in this one, unfortunately. And I did use these new kind of wall-leaning signs that we got in that free update as well. I wanted to try and use as many of those things as I possibly could, because I haven't really done a build with them yet, so I wanted to make sure I was incorporating those as much as possible. Over here, we have the yoga studio. So the yoga studio is made up of, I would say, two main parts. So obviously, one of the main areas is this room here, which is the actual physical yoga studio. And I was playing around with debug earlier in the build, just because I was looking for some cars and things, but I didn't realize that when we got the new cars from Strangerville that they were the junk cars that's like half a car. So I couldn't really, you know, see myself putting those in the parking lot. So I ended up just having the debug menu open for most, if not all, of this build. And while I was there, while I was searching for yoga mats, I realized that there is a specific yoga mat that you need to have a yoga instructor come to the lot. I did not know this, guys. I don't know how many spas and how many yoga studios have I built that I have not put in the instructor's yoga mat. Like, I am so mad at myself for not knowing, because I've gone into builds and been like, why on earth is there no yoga instructor? Why are there no yoga classes? Why is no one doing yoga? I'm really confused. And it was like really frustrating for me to be building these yoga studios and not having them work. I was really confused, but now I figured it out. Apparently, you have to put in a specific yoga mat that your instructor will stand on and teach the class on. Who knew? Who knew? And then I realized I found that little juice kind of bar thing, and I tried to put it in the juice bar, I guess, and it just didn't end up working out. So I don't think that I end up using that particular item. But in this yoga studio, I did end up putting a few of the massage chairs in here, as well as a nice little seating area so your Sims can sit and wait while they are, you know, prepping for their yoga class. And then, of course, we do have two changing rooms / bathrooms. You do have to have a storage locker, toilet, sink, and I'm pretty sure you have to have a shower in the spa. So I did include the shower. I feel like that's appropriate. If you are going somewhere where you're probably going to be sweating, you're likely going to want to take a shower afterwards. So there is a shower in here. There's two of them. So hopefully that is enough for every single Sim that, you know, approaches the yoga studio. And now looking at this, I do realize that I did do a men's shower and a women's shower. So they are separate, and it's only in the yoga studio that they are gender specific. So I really like the way that the bathrooms turned out. I think they are super neat and sleek looking. I would have no problem showering in here if this was a yoga studio that I attended. I know that in some gyms and, you know, just different types of fitness places, some of the showers are a little on the, like, I'm not showering there kind of area. I've been to a few gyms, and I honestly don't think that I've ever taken a shower at a gym, because they just super gross me out. I don't want to. I will just go home and take my shower and deal with the fact that I am sweaty all the way home. I'm totally okay with that, as long as it means I don't actually have to shower inside of a gym. But if my gym showers looked like these showers, I think that I would be more inclined to do it. So I wanted to make sure I was taking up a little bit more space in here. I did not want it to be just the yoga mats. I felt like that was really boring. So at my yoga studio, and actually most fitness places that I teach, there is, whether it be a table or a shelf on the wall, there is somewhere where there is a radio or radio controls of some kind. So I figured putting a table back here with the radio on it, and then maybe some flowers, some candles, some incense, that kind of thing, I thought that really made sense for the yoga studio. And then I did end up using that little ottoman that has kind of like the little towels and the candles and stuff on it. I always forget that exists until I see it. And then every time I see it, I'm like, oh my God, I need to use this. I love it. And I did end up changing the colors of the yoga mats. I thought maybe this is a little bit more of a higher end yoga studio. Maybe they put the yoga mats out for you and they are very color coordinated. They look really nice and put together. And then I felt like the back wall was pretty empty compared to the rest of it. So I thought maybe just some shelving with some towels, some incense, some candles, that kind of thing. So I did end up using these rolled up towels. I thought those were perfect for what I was looking for. I do wish that you could place down the yoga mat folded up as well. I think that would be a really cool idea just to kind of have some yoga mats leaning against the wall. But, you know, we can't always get what we want. It's The Sims. We get what we're given. So I suppose that I'll deal with it. But I do think these little shelves looked pretty cute. I did end up changing up the door just because it was really bothering me that it was not completely centered. And then I realized since the door wasn't centered, neither were my shelves. So I had to fix all of my shelves. But I think it turned out pretty good. I really, really enjoy this. This is definitely a build that I'm going to be playing in. It is already up on the gallery for you guys, so if you want to go download this from the gallery, my origin ID is hiphiprenee. It's all lowercase, spelled just like it is here, so you can definitely head over to the gallery and check it out. Let me know how you enjoy playing in it if you do download it. I really love hearing people, you know, who play in my builds or even take some screenshots and send them to me. I would love to see those. That would be really fun. And then we are just going to be finishing up this little back office here, and then we're going to head into the screenshots. So I really hope that you guys enjoyed this build. I had a lot of fun doing it. I am a little bit more motivated for hip rebuilds now. Not that I wasn't before, but I think this one kind of sparked me a little bit again. So I am excited to work on a few more community lots and get some more houses done. I do have a little bit of a backlog as far as families for hip rebuilds are concerned. I have a few of them to work with and to build lots for. But if you want your family featured on Hip Rebuild, make sure you upload them to the gallery with the hashtag Hip Rebuilds. If I haven't said it enough, it's Hip Rebuilds. So thank you guys so much for joining me today. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up down below. I would really appreciate it. If you're new here or you're not new here and you're not subscribed yet, make sure you hit that subscribe button and hit that little bell so you get notifications every single time I post a new video. I will be back with you guys on Wednesday with yet another speed build. Thank you guys so much, and I'll see you next time. Bye.